Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Midwest Market Solutions Insider Commentaries. Tuesday morning, it is October the 3rd. Thanks for joining us here. Overnight, FC Stone came out with their yield estimates. They're right in line with previous USDA numbers. This is a field survey, so it's kind of confirming what we're hearing as far as yields that have been harvested so far. They put corn at 169.2 bushels per acre, soybeans at 49.9 bushels per acre. Again, right in line with what the USDA is currently forecasting. Informa will be out on Thursday morning, I am told, and they will update their estimates. And they always talk what the USDA will say that particular month or that report. So they're going to forecast what USDA is going to say in October, not what the actual crop is or what the final yields will be. Of course, we're talking about numbers ahead of the supply and demand report that'll be out a week from this Thursday. Egypt tendered for wheat overnight. None of the wheat looks to be sourced from anywhere except Russia. Russia's going to get this wheat tender, it certainly looks like, nothing from the U.S. And wheat has tried to rally off of the news, the Egyptian tender overnight and oversold conditions of the wheat market over the last couple days, but could give back some of those gains here as the results are actually released. I'll be doing RFD TV a little bit later this morning, 10:15 Central Time, so we hope you have a chance to check that out. We'll be sending out the link or the program file for that in a few days, but hope you have a chance to look at it today. In the grains, I think just very some quiet to mixed trade here. No private export sale announcements to talk about. We had one yesterday. We also had harvest delays yesterday, or forecast for them to develop, and that failed to rally the corn and soybean markets. So it's market's really struggling here. Soybeans right on an uptrend line. I think this is where they need to bounce from to maintain that uptrend, but really don't have the news or right now the momentum to push above it. Cattle futures, I think, got oversold yesterday. They really didn't have bad enough news to have the big losses that we had. I think we could see some sort of a bounce here today. The show lists are much larger than a week ago, suggesting cash trade will be lower this week. We hope you have a great day. Good luck and good trading, everyone. And we hope to talk to you soon. This has been Brian Hoops for Midwest Markets.